God had chosen Moses to lead his people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt, where they had been imprisoned for over 400 years. God wanted Moses to lead the people to the promised land. On their journey, God had them stop at Mount Sinai because he was anxious to renew his promises that he had made to their great-great-great-great-grandfather Abraham. See, God wanted to tell them that he was going to be with them forever. He was going to give them their own land and eternal life. But instead of answering God the way their great-great-great-great-grandfather Abraham did, who said, when God gave him the promises, "Thank you, I believe you," the children of Israel said, "Okay, God, everything you said we'll do." But in a few days, they forgot God. They built a golden image, they bowed down and worshipped it, and they even had a wild party in front of it to make God really sad. God gave a test to Moses, because he wanted Moses to understand why Jesus would have to come die for us. So God said to Moses, "Don't try to stop me. I'm going to go down and I'm going to kill those people. And then I'm going to make you and your family a great nation." Did that sound appealing to Moses? No. Moses said, "Oh God, I know these people have sinned terribly. Please forgive them. But if you can't forgive them, then take my name out of your book of life, which you've written all the names of your people in. Because if they must die forever, thank you for your promises. Lord, we ask that we would be part of that generation that would say, "Yes, please put your agape love in my heart." Thank you for hearing our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.